One of the problems that overlooked professionals and business owners, business leaders bring to their coaching sessions with me is around reputation and how they are perceived by other people. And quite often, it fascinates me to see how people lack a level of self-awareness around how they communicate and how they come across, and therefore how other people might be perceiving them as an individual and how they might be experiencing those things and messages that those people are looking to communicate, or those clients are looking to communicate. And what's really fascinating, more so for me here, is the notion that words create worlds, and how the words that you use can fundamentally shift or shape the relationships that you have with people in your business or within your client group, and how the words therefore have to be very carefully selected. And this is something that I personally find quite a challenge, because I tend to verbalize what's in my head. There's quite often very little interaction between what's going on here and what comes out of here for me. And therefore, I often myself struggle with this issue. An example is a conversation that I was having the other day with somebody about how they don't believe themselves, and how they listen to the words that they use, and they look at the reaction that brings about in other people that they're working with or communicating with. And they don't quite understand why they don't say what they mean. And I said to this woman, how long are you going to go on lying to yourself? Now, that to me was a really obvious question to ask. But her reaction was one of immense anger and frustration. And she said, "How dare you call me a liar?" And I said, No. Let's just be really clear. I'm using a word that makes sense to me, and lying to me is just a manifestation, a representation of the situation that you say you find yourself in." And she proceeded to get more and more and more agitated by the notion that me, as her coach and as her partner in this learning experience, thought that she was a liar. And we decided to spend a little time in this space exploring what exactly is going on for you here. And what we discovered was that this woman had had this challenge her entire life. And growing up, her parents had called her Billy Liar, which in itself was absolutely fascinating. And so she had grown up into a woman in her late 50s, believing that she was a liar, and therefore not believing in herself and the words that she uses. And the impact that this was having on her business relationships and her relationships with her clients was absolutely fascinating, but also fairly significant. And it was meaning she was not getting the traction she was wanting, and she wasn't gaining the success or the opportunities that she felt she deserved. So my message to you is this: communication and what you communicate is all about the recipient and how they experience what you say and do. So, whilst you might be using words and language that make sense to you, if you're not careful, they can be misinterpreted, and over time, those words can create a world view for the other person about who you are and how you operate.